welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a tutorial on this makeup look that I'm wearing. I don't normally play with yellows, but I got inspired by Crispy on Instagram. She's a really, really great makeup artist. She posted a yellow look on Instagram and I really liked it and was inspired by it. So I wanted to film this look for you guys. I really like how it turned out. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. If you want to see how I created this look, then please keep watching.
I'm starting off by using this NYX color corrector in the shade orange. I'm going to be applying that around my mouth and under my eyes to hide any darkness and discoloration. Next, I'm going to apply my foundation. I'm using a drugstore foundation and it's the L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Makeup in the shade W8, which is called Creme Cafe. I'm applying that all over my face and blending in with a damp beauty blender. Next, I'm moving on to priming my eyelids. I'm using the Soft Ochre Paint Pot by MAC. Going in with my first eyeshadow. This is by Makeup Forever in the shade M704. And I'm using that as my transition color. Here I'm going in with the second color, and it's also by Makeup Forever in the shade M738. I'm using a small dense brush to apply this color and then going back and blending it in with a blending brush. Normally in between each color that I apply, I go in with a clean blending brush and I blend everything together. Next, I'm using Red Brick by MAC to add a little bit more warmth to the look. I'm applying that in my crease as well. Here, I'm taking that same paint pot and I'm gonna carve out my crease. This is gonna give me a really crisp shape that I'm looking for. And I'm just following my natural eye shape here. Next, I'm applying the lid color. This is also by MAC in the shade Chrome Yellow. Using a flat shader brush, I'm applying that and staying below the crease. Here I'm going in with another Makeup Forever shadow in the shade M628. And I'm going to use that to define my crease a bit more. Taking a small angled brush and just darkening up the crease area. You want to be very careful with this step. You don't want to get any of that dark color onto the lid. I'm also doing small flicking motions, flicking upwards towards my crease and staying away from my lid space. Here I'm just blending it all in so it looks seamless. Next, I'm taking the shade from the Morphe 350 palette and I'm applying this to the outer V area just to smoke it out a bit. And I'm only placing this color in the outer V. I'm not bringing it very far into the crease area. Next, to make it a little bit darker, I'm going in with a black eyeshadow and that same angled brush and just defining the crease and the outer V a little bit more. And you want to blend that out as much as possible so it's smooth and seamless. As you can see, I've done my brows off camera to save time. Here, I'm going in with my concealer. I'm using the Kevin Aucoin Sensual Skin Enhancer in SX11. I've had that concealer for a while now, and I really do love it. You get a lot of product for the price, so it lasts a very long time. And I'm using it to highlight under my eyes. And I'm also going to use that color to help contour my nose as well, adding a bit to my chin and forehead. And I have an in-depth video on how to contour and highlight on my channel if you're interested. Using my beauty blender to blend it all out. I love the beauty blender for under eye concealer and foundation really. I don't really use brushes for my face makeup, only eyeshadows. The beauty blender helps to sheer everything out for a natural look. If you're looking for more full coverage, I would definitely use a brush to apply my foundation and concealer. Here I'm going in with the Benai Banana Powder to set my highlighted areas under my eyes and my nose, forehead, and chin. Next, I'm going in with my face powder to set my foundation. I'm using the Naked Skin Ultra Definition Powder in the shade Medium Dark Golden. As you can see, I've hit pan on that, but I won't be buying another one. This was my second time purchasing it. I do like it, but I want to venture out and try some other powders. So if you have any recommendations, let me know. Here I'm using a huge powder brush to set my foundation to make sure it lasts all day. Next, I'm going in with the Bahama Mama Bronzer by The Balm. I do like this bronzer. If you are of a deeper skin tone, I wouldn't recommend it if you are deeper than me because it may not show up. Here, I'm just contouring my nose. Next, I'm going to snatch my cheekbones with this same bronzer. I place the product down with that flat top brush first, and then I'll go in with a different brush and blend it all out. Here I'm applying some bronzer to my chin to take care of that double chin area and also my forehead to make my forehead appear slimmer. Here I'm adding some of that chrome yellow to my lower lash line. Pretty much for the bottom lash line, I go in with the same exact colors I used on my lids. Going in with those Makeup Forever shades that I used in my crease on the lower lash line, just to warm up the look a little bit and smoke it out. Now I'm applying one of the darker shades I used in the Morphe 350 palette to add some drama. Here I'm going in with my Slayla lashes by Flutter Lashes. I do love these lashes and recommend them if you're looking for a really nice lash that's not too expensive. Here I'm going in with the Anastasia Glow Kit and I'm using those two shades there to highlight my cheekbones. Also going to highlight the tip of my nose and the inner tear ducts. Here I'm going in with a blush by MAC and applying that to my cheeks. And finally, I'm applying my lip color by Dose of Colors in the shade Cork. And this is a beautiful nude. And here I'm adding the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray.
All right, y'all, that wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, you know what to do. Give it a like and subscribe, and also leave a comment down in the comments section. And you guys are welcome to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter. I'll leave links to those down below in the description box. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.